Hello children, welcome back to the educational channel. Before this we have studied the lesson of 8th standard, that is health and hygiene. In this lesson we have just studied some of the types of disease. How are the disease classified on the basis of the occurrence and on the basis of the period for which they occur. Now let us study something detail about that. Now we have seen that the infectious disease, they spread from person to person. How do they spread? By what agent, by what medium do they spread? Which are the causing agents? And what are the symptoms for this disease? So let us study the infectious diseases. Now you all know that they are spreading from one person to the another by different methods, by different agents. You can say they are the food, water, air, or they are spreading by the touch. So now here in this video we are going to discuss some of the infectious diseases and the details about those diseases. Now in your textbook, you have this chart of the infectious disease. The infectious diseases are the diseases that spread through the contaminated air, water, food, or the vectors like insect and other animals. Now let us see what are the infectious diseases. Now first let us discuss about the names of the infectious diseases. Here some of them are tuberculosis, hepatitis, dysentery, cholera, and typhoid. So let us start with the first disease, that is the tuberculosis. In short, we name this disease as TB. Now this disease, named as tuberculosis, in short we say it TB, it is spreading because of the pathogen. Pathogen is just the microorganism that spreads the disease. The microorganism that harms us, that is called as pathogen. And the pathogen causing the tuberculosis is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Now this Mycobacterium tuberculosis, you can see here it is written in italic. So it's the rule, the scientific name you have to write in the italic, either bold or you have to underline. So this tuberculosis, TB, spreads with the help of the pathogen called as Mycobacterium tuberculosis. How does this Mycobacterium tuberculosis enter our body? That is called as mode of infection. Now first thing, spitting by patient through air, when the patient who is suffering from the TB, he spits in the air, then the Mycobacterium tuberculosis, that is the microorganisms present in his body, that enter the air, and they can enter our body if we breathe in that air. Prolonged contact with and sharing of materials of patient. Suppose if that person is having TB and if we are sharing the things of that person, like if we share the towel or if we share the handkerchief or the clothing or the bedding, even the utensils of that TB person, they are kept separated, because if he is having that disease, then the bacterium Mycobacterium tuberculosis is present in his spittle, in his inhalation and exhalation also. So whatever the air he is breathing and exhaling, that may contain these organisms. So it is very harmful to be in contact with the TB patient. The spittle contains the bacterium, so wherever he spits, that spittle should be disinfected, and the things he use, that should be kept separated. Now symptoms, how can we know that the person is suffering from the tuberculosis? The symptoms are chronic cough means generally we have the cough, but that lasts for 2 days, 3 days, or maximum 8 days. But if it's a chronic cough means from a long period of time, for a month he is having the cough, that is a chronic cough. Bloody spitting means from his spittle blood can come out. Emaciation, difficult breathing, that is he finds difficult for breathing because of the bacterium present inside his body. How to prevent the disease called as tuberculosis? So preventive and the treatment. BCG vaccine, this is given to the each newborn child, so that person may not get the tuberculosis disease in his future. Isolation of the patient means that person should be kept in a separate room so that his bacterium should not enter the person of the another body. Regular medication like DOT. So this is the treatment, or this is the medicine given to that patient. All this about the tuberculosis. Now let us see the second disease, that is the hepatitis. Hepatitis is called as jaundice. In the simple language, in the common language, we just call it as yellow fever. This is caused by the hepatitis virus A, B, C, D, E. So these are the different viruses causing the hepatitis, that is the jaundice, that is the yellow fever. How does it infects our body? The contaminated water, sharing of needles, blood transfusion, etc. Contaminated water means this virus enters our body through the water, or if the needle or the blood of that suffering person is used to another person, it may get contaminated or the infection occurs. What are the symptoms here? The main symptoms are anorexia, yellow urine, general weakness, nausea, vomiting, and gray stools. It means if we say it yellow fever because that person looks yellow, he looks yellow because the blood in his body has decreased. So the urine is looking yellow. General weakness, as he is suffering from disease, he is becoming weak and weak. Nausea, that is he may become unconscious, he may fall. Vomiting and the gray stool, that is his waste product, his excretory material, that waste gray stool, it is a symptom of having the jaundice. How can it be prevented? It can be just prevented by drinking the boiled water or by proper cleaning of the hands. If you drink the boiled water, you may not get the jaundice because it just goes from one person to another person by the contaminated water and by proper cleaning of the hands, so that it may not enter our body. The next is the dysentery. Dysentery is the disease. This person having the dysentery has to go to washroom again and again. That is the dysentery. It is caused because of the pathogen called as bacteria, virus, and in that is the Shigella bacilli, Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica is the one name. So Entamoeba histolytica, that is the name of one single organism, one single microorganism. And this dysentery occurs because of the contaminated food and water. So always it is necessary that you wash your hands before eating. Do not eat the food from the vendors, from the outside stalls which are open, because they may be contaminated by these pathogens. What happens when there is dysentery? Watery stool, pains in the abdomen. Watery stool, that is again and again that person has to go to washroom and just the stool is watery. Watery stool, that is again the name for the waste product. Watery stool and pains in the abdomen, too much pain. How can it be prevented? Simple thing, drinking of boiled water, because it is getting contaminated from water. So if we all drink boiled water, those organisms will not enter our body. And proper storage of food, ORS consumption. Drinking boiled water and proper storage of food, these are the preventive measures, and ORS consumption is the treatment. ORS consumption means it's just the powder that you have to mix in the water and drink, because when there is watery stool, all the minerals from our body are getting decreased, so there is nothing in the body. If you eat again, you will have to go to the washroom, so nothing is there inside the stomach. You may feel less of energy. For that, ORS consumption, that gives you all the required minerals. Next is the cholera. It occurs because of the pathogen called as Vibrio cholerae, that is the bacterium, and the mode of infection here, it is the contaminated food and water. The person who is suffering from cholera has vomiting, severe diarrhea, and cramps in legs. Cramps in legs means the legs are paining too much. Diarrhea, that is again that person has to go to washroom again and again, and vomiting because this bacterium is present inside the intestine, and the body does not allow the foreign particles to come inside, and hence that person again does the vomiting again and again. Now, how to prevent this? It is just prevented by following the hygienic practice. Means if the person is following the cleanliness practice, cholera may not occur. Avoiding open place food, drinking boiled water, vaccination against cholera. If you do all this, you cannot get the disease. And the last one we are going to discuss, that is the typhoid. Typhoid, we just said that is the fever, high fever. and that is caused by the pathogen called as Salmonella typhi, that is a bacterium, and the mode of infection is the contaminated food of water. Now the symptoms, that is again anorexia, headache, rash on the abdomen, dysentery, fever up to 104 degree Fahrenheit, that is too much hot. The body becomes too much hot because there are the bacterium present inside the body. How to prevent this? Drinking clean water, vaccination, proper disposal of sewage, etc. If you drink clean water, it will not enter your body and you will not get the typhoid. Vaccination, this is the best way. And proper disposal of sewage. Because of the sewage, because of the wastewater, the bacterium grows and that bacteria may enter the body of the human. So as to avoid the typhoid, you have to do proper disposal of the sewage. So here we have discussed some of the infectious disease, their pathogens, the mode of infection, symptoms, and the preventive measures and the treatment. So I hope you liked all the information. You understood each and every point properly. Now like and comment how was the video. Subscribe the channel so that you can get again the further information in simple and easy language of all the classes. Thank you.